And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the New York Mets going up against the Kansas City Royals. Alongside Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. And Chris, a couple of rookies getting to start in the mound in this one.
Yeah, guys are always trying to prove themselves, and I think one way of separating yourself from people in your class is outperforming that guy on the other side, and I think that's what we're going to see in this one for sure.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go now. And towing the slab in this one, Asa Lacy.
Well, he got into the eighth inning his last time out, really pitching deep into games as of late. We'll see today how many innings he's got in him.
All right, ready to go here. Here's Brandon Nimmo.
The center fielder, number 9, Brandon Nimmo.
The pitch. Into center and a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
Waste no time there. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
And now it's Frankie Lindor. In there for strike one. Nimmo gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Step off, throw to first. Nimmo back in standing. That one pushed foul. Singy, where are you on F1 racing? Are you a fan?
Haven't gotten there yet, but I will at some point.
Francisco Lindor, a big fan of F1 racing. His favorite driver is Lewis Hamilton. Eaton drops steps, heads back on it. Tries to make the play, but it's foul. Runner at first with no outs here. Base hit, center field.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Jeff McNeil stands in now, looks at that one inside. Entering this one second in the National League in hitting. And a pitch.
Outside, that's a ball.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. 2-ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
And he deals. Swing and a miss.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit. Slightly up, slightly in.
Swing and a miss. And it's 2-2. At the belt and fires. Got him. One away.
Now, Boog, it becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging it or if you want to give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him, and you're just hoping that somehow, some way it'll click and he can get out of this as quickly as possible.
2-1, 1-out. So up next for New York, Pete Alonso went deep in the ball game last night. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
That one is absolutely belted. That's got a chance. Gone. Pete Alonso with a shot to the opposite field. And that gives him a lead. It's 3-0. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to hit. That one finds the zone. It's 0-1. The wind of the pitch. Strike two.
Backdoored him with a breaking ball. Just got the corner. There's nothing you can really do with that.
Next one misses, and that is ball one.
It's a good take.
Next pitch inside, and it's 2-2. Still only one out here in the inning. And that one is lifted in the air. Eaton should have this one. And there's two away.
Batting six, the designated hitter, Starling.
Here's Starling Marte, one of the stars in the win yesterday, as he had three hits. Just missed. Next offering is fouled back.
Well, they're really running up the pitch count in this first inning. Lots of confidence from this team that is perhaps the hottest in baseball right now.
Next offering misses. 2-1.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Here's a 2-2. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Here's Mark Canna. And there's a ball. Marte off of first with two away. Runner on the goal. Pitch in for a strike. Tag save. The throw from Perez too late.
Well, he had that base stolen as soon as he broke for second. Such a huge lead. The pitcher's got to find a way to help out his catcher, especially if he doesn't have a great throwing arm. Step off the rubber, shrink that lead somehow, create a little bit more time, or maybe you can prevent that stolen base.
That one ran inside, almost got him. Fouls one off, 2-2. Two outs and one in scoring position. Liner, base hit. Marte is waved home. He'll score, and it's 4-0.
Picks himself up an RBI. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
So up next, Francisco Alvarez. And there's the strike.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound. And this is one of those where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
And now the 0-1. And a swing and a miss there.
Well, clear game plan coming in this one. Be aggressive against this starter. Try to knock him out of this ball game, and it looks like.
Got him swinging. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. So they move out in front after a four-run outburst. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Mets 4, KC coming to bat. Back here at the ballpark. And on the hill in this one, Kodai Senga. Singy, he's kind of a road warrior, yeah?
I definitely say so. You know, some guys shrink a little bit on the road. They're so used to just, you know, having the comforts of being at home and having the fans behind them. But this guy seems to thrive in adversity and being in some hostile environment. So when you have a player like this on your team that goes out there and competes, you definitely like your chances away from your home ballpark.
So up now for Kansas City, number 11. And a pitch. And that one is inside. Senga, a former All-Star. He features a four-seam fastball, a forkball, a cutter, and he works in a slider. And it's 1-1.
1-1.
And strike two.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. And the pitch.
Ball two.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, that right there is just a pitcher's pitch. Tailing away from the hitter, lowing away with some good action at the end. You know, even if he gets the bat to that ball, it's probably just a weak ground ball to the opposite side. I tell you what, that's a tremendous two-strike pitch.
Now at the plate, Michael Massey. Pitches in for a strike. 0-1. One down, base is empty. And ball one.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
Hard hit, left side. Toss to Alonso. Two up, two down.
Batting third. The first baseman.
Two outs, base is empty. And now the first baseman, Vinny Pasquantino. Three hits and a loss last night. That misses. And that's ball one. Next offering is fouled back. And 1-2. Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Royals bats are quiet there. They trail it here 4-0. Back here in Kansas City, now batting Tim LoCastro.
The right fielder, Tim LoCastro.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. 2013 in the playoffs, you caught one as the Red Sox played the Rays in the division series.
I sacrificed a bracelet. It was my wrist and my hand. Gosh, a little late on that breaking ball. I don't think he recognized it out of the hand. Just a little tardy. Gonna have to regroup here.
Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. And now 1-2. fouls it off. Still 1-2. Singy wasn't very sharp in the first. Got hit around a little bit. Just wasn't able to locate particularly well. A lot of stuff in the fat part of the plate.
Yeah, Boog, he wasn't fooling anyone. It's a tough place to be because it's not always obvious what adjustments need to be made. Sometimes it's location. Sometimes it's being too predictable. Sometimes you're tipping your pitches. He's going to need to figure it out quickly, though.
And now the lefty cut on and missed, struck him out, and now one away.
The center fielder,
Brandon Nimmo, the next to hit, scored the first run of the game back in the first after a single to reach base. There's a strike. That one fouled off. On the ground. Bare hand grab to first. On the money. Nice play.
Now batting. Francisco Lindor.
Two outs. Base is empty. Now up to hit, Francisco Lindor. Swing and a miss. That's strike one. Francisco Lindor, a guy who's won multiple gold gloves and a platinum glove, multiple all-star appearances. Mr. Smile, what do you think of when you contemplate the player Francisco Lindor?
Just a special talent, both sides of the ball, both sides of the plate equally.
Well, we'll hold that thought as that's the third out, and we'll end the inning. Mets go down quickly, but they lead it 4-0. And welcome back. And now it's Salvador Perez to the plate.
The catcher.
Senga back to work. Just missed. Nowadays, with advanced metrics and increased use of moving the infielders around, defense isn't necessarily about making errors. Are you able to get to the ball? Are you able to position fielders where guys hit the ball, but within the new shift rules? Lifted in the air, right field. LoCastro has a bead on it, hauls it in, and there's one away.
In an area that goes unnoticed is the coach that's responsible for positioning and then the research person that's providing the information. So what we're seeing in baseball, so many more people behind the scenes that are contributing to the success between the lines.
And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. Now 1-1. Mike Fillmore, our plate umpire, very consistent with his zone, Chris, gets a lot of praise for that.
He does, Boog, and I think that with any umpire, you really just want them to be consistent. Fillmore's a guy that does a good job back there in that way, so people around the league really appreciate his consistency.
Next pitch misses way outside. What about some no-nos? Like, you can't call the umpire blue the way you do in Little League or high school, right?
Yeah, even in the minor leagues, you'll learn quickly. You call the umpire blue. You better learn his name. And that's just part of being a professional player and even a major league player.
Now it's Franmil Reyes. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
Foul ball, it stays 0-2. The pitch. Got him swinging. Royals go down 1-2-3. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. back here at Kauffman Stadium, all set for the start of the inning. Yeah, the batter now, Jeff McNeil.
McNeil.
Here comes a pitch. That one missed.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning, so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
Comes up empty. That's strike two. Not even close there. Two balls, two strikes. Kicks and deals. Ground ball left side. And he beats it. He's safe.
Oh, it's just such a tough play for a third baseman. Fielding on your backhand and then trying to get off such a long throw across the diamond with a quick enough release to get it there in time. Really only the best at the position can pull that off. And I think that extra step to set his feet cost him a little bit right there.
Man at first, Pete Alonso up now for the Mets. That one misses. Ball one. Couple of quick nuggets on Pete Alonso. He graduated from the same high school as Wade Boggs, Plant High School in the Tampa area. And Alonso also played at the University of Florida. He was teammates there with Harrison Bader. In the dirt, and the runner holds. Now 3-0. And he walked him.
Well, we've seen this recipe cook up a big inning plenty of times. Two runners on, nobody out, and they're in the heart of their order. It's just a great opportunity to put up a crooked number.
Eduardo Escobar up now for the Mets. And the pitch is outside, ball one. McNeil over at second. Alonso at first with no outs. And another ball.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
And a pitch. And that misses upstairs. Now 3-0.
Good pitchers make pitches in big situations. And right here with a middle of the order hitter up, runner in scoring position, he's got to find a way to throw a quality strike.
And the 3-1. And they're all loaded up.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Boog. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Starling Marte up to hit. The walk and a run scored his first time. On the ground, could be two. There's one. And a run scores on the double play.
It's always great when you can add a run, but in this situation with the bases loaded, double play is kind of a rally killer.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Asa Lacy out of the game. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. So the Royals bring on a new arm, Josh Stamont.
I think it's got to be a little tough coming in out of the pen when your guys are trailing so big on the scoreboard. Just doesn't have the same intensity to it, but he's got to find a way because these batters count the same for his stats, obviously, regardless of the score.
Digging in, Mark Canna. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. Swinging a foul straight back. That's a base hit, run scores.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
So two down. Here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
He was a strikeout victim his first time. Stamon, 29 years old, and he was a second-round pick back in 2015. Righty delivers. And a foul ball. Ball and a strike. Hit hard. That gets through. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Now batting. Right.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there was just no one there to knock it down.
And next for the Mets, Tim LoCastro.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
And that's outside. And that's ball one. Just off the outside part of the plate.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
Bounce to third. Stops it on a slide. The throw, it's there, and that's a great play. They put two on the board, three hits, no errors, but two are left stranded. We head down to the home half of inning number three. It's the Mets 6 and the Royals nothing. Welcome back. Drew Waters stands in.
Every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs. This is one of those times when you want to be aggressive. Go ahead and pitch to contact. Let the defense work behind you. You've got a nice, comfortable lead. Don't try to be too fine.
Lindor pulls that one down, and there's one down.
Batting it, the third baseman, Hunter.
Here's Hunter Dozier to the dish.
Dozier.
One for four with a triple last night. Dozier in his seventh season in the eighth spot in today's lineup. A former first-round pick back in 2013. And a foul ball. Next pitch misses outside. One and one. Good eye right there.
I can't play around with him here. It's a six-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Right-hander kicks, deals. Battling here as he fouls it away. The next offering misses, and that's ball three. Struck him out swinging. Slider got him for strike three.
Well, that's the moneymaker right there. Two strikes, slider down and away from a same side thrower as the hitter. I mean, that's just tough. You're looking to protect with two strikes and very difficult to lay off.
Nate Eaton stands in now and watches strike one. Next pitch is outside.
Really nice slider right there, sweeping across the dish, but just couldn't hang the edge.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout. Nothing doing for the Royals. Still up against a 6-0 deficit. Back here at the ballpark, and now it's going to be Brandon Nimmo.
Brandon Nimmo.
The pitch. Good eye right there. So two balls and no strikes.
He's been raking in recent games, and a big reason why, getting ahead in counts. He's been able to do that consistently, and you see the results.
The why to kick the pitch. Fly ball to right. Eaton drifts towards it. Puts it away for the out.
The batter, the shortstop.
Here's Francisco Lindor. One home run shy of 200 for his career. Swing and a miss, and it's 0-1.
Great velocity at 97 at the top of the zone.
0-2 as he waves at that one.
They can live up in the zone all game if guys will chase it. That's just too much velocity. Hitters got to look down in the zone.
Next offering upstairs.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
And the righty deals. Look out! And it hit him. He had him 1-2, and he ends up hitting him with a pitch.
Well, the bright side is that that will help the on-base percentage a little bit, and that's a category no batter can ignore these days. OBP, OPS, well, maybe that'll ease the pain just a little bit.
On the ground, left side, 6-4-3, double play, and the inning is over. So they make short work of him there. We're midway in the fourth. It's the Mets 6 and the Royals nothing. And welcome back. John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, number 21. Senga back to work. They say it went.
All ones the count.
And fouled off. Bounce to the right side. Now the throw to first on the run. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Michael Massey steps in for the Royals. Grounded out to short in his first trip. There's a strike. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Drops for a hit. He couldn't run it down.
Now back. He obviously put a very nice swing on that pitch and really drove it towards the gap, but I'm pretty surprised he only ended up on first right there, and it's kind of hard to say if there was some hesitation or if they just decided to play it safe.
Pasquantino in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Struck out swinging his first time. Massey at first, one gone. Fly ball down the line. Pulls it in on the run. Two down.
The catcher, number 13.
Stepping in, the long ball threat, Salvador Perez. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. Salvi is a star in Kansas City. He debuted with the Royals as a 21-year-old, helped them win a World Series in 2015. In fact, he did more than help. He ended up being the World Series MVP. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for
sets him down on strikes. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. So one left for Kansas City. They still find themselves down. 6-0. Back here in Kansas City, here's Pete Alonso. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
The wind of the pitch. And there's a ball.
Well, these Mets really impressing me with the quality of their at-bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. It looked to me like they really wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the game before he settles in. So I'd say mission accomplished.
And now 2-0. And a big swing and a miss.
Well, that's today's style of baseball right there, right? Big time velo on the bump and big time pop at the plate.
That one drifts inside.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
3-1 now. And that one fouled off. Payoff pitch. That one ripped. And in one hops the wall. Now he turns and heads for second. He's in there.
He was all over that one. Got a fastball, middle of the plate, jumped all over it. Absolutely smoked that ball.
Escobar.
Here's the third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Man at second. And that one pulled foul. Runner at second, nobody out. That one blasted deep to right. That's back. That one is gone. Eduardo Escobar leaves the park. Home run number 10 of the year. It's 8-0.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
And now the Mets DH, Starling Marte. In there, and it's 0-1. Left field makes the grab, one away.
Now batting the left fielder,
Mark Canna, up now for the Mets.
Really nice swing in his last at bat. Shot a line drive into center field.
That one's in there. It's 0-1. They say it went.
0-2.
The 0-2. Got him looking. Couldn't pull the trigger on a fastball at the knees.
Well, that at-bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at-bat.
Two outs, base is empty. Francisco Alvarez getting ready to hit. And ball one.
Count 1-0.
And the 1-0 to third. Slings to first. That ends the frame. Mets add two runs on this blast. It's now an 8-0 game. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here at Kauffman Stadium, we head to the bottom of the fifth and to the plate for Kansas City, Edward Olivares.
Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
Swing and a line drive curling foul down the right side. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, he's showing some pretty dominating stuff out there in this one, not just in terms of swing and miss, but also in terms of command. You know, all of the strikeouts, they kind of speak for themselves, but when you don't walk anyone, you're demonstrating that you have the confidence in your abilities to truly go right after opposing batters.
Reyes takes a ball as he stands in for the second time. The 1-0. And that's a strike.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Next one misses, and it's 2-1.
2-1.
Hard hit, right side. And he takes it himself for the out.
The center fielder, number 6, Drew.
And next up for the Royals, Drew Waters. He's 0-1. And that's in for a strike. And a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Only two hits allowed so far tonight, Boog, so I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
Two outs, runner at first. Now the third baseman, Hunter Dozier. 0-1, he struck out swinging last time. A strike.
Well, he's been incredibly efficient in this one. First pitch strike percentage over 70%. That's well above league average, and that's what's allowed him to pitch well up until this point.
Lifted in the air down the left side. Lindor under it. And that is that. Royals lead one, still 8-0. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Taylor Clark.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
Tim LoCastro digs in now. And a pitch. And that's in for a strike. LoCastro, in his fifth season, 30 years old now, he joined the team as a free agent. That's out to center field. And that'll fall for a base hit.
Boog, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
And now the center fielder, Brandon Nimmo, 1-3. That one's in there, 0-1. Clark measures 6 feet 4 inches. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, and he works in a changeup. LoCastro aboard here at first with nobody out. Next offering is in for a strike. Activity in the bullpen. Chris Bubich appears to be getting loose.
runner. Yes,
here
yes.
comes the pitch. There goes the runner from first. In there for strike three. Safe at second, and he easily steals the bag.
The shortstop, Francisco.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. One for two.
His next home run will be the 200th in his career. It would be pretty cool to see it right here.
Pickoff throw, and LoCastro dives back in. Here's the pitch. Runner breaks for third. There's a ball, and safe. It's a stolen base.
Wow, these guys are merciless. I'd say a questionable decision to steal third right there with the big lead. Probably won't be received well in the other dugout.
Runner on at third, one gone. Next offering is fouled back. The 1-1. And there's a foul ball. Here's a 1-2. Check swing, no appeal. One away with a runner at third. Gets a piece and stays alive. The next pitch misses, and the count's full.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
And here's a 3-2. And there's ball four.
You get a walk, and you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
Jeff.
And now here's Jeff McNeil. Singy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. This one lifted in the air, left field, and a base hit knocks in a run. Cut off, now a throw home. Not in time. He's safe as a run scores.
Comes through with the RBI. That's a ball that a lot of times you'll see the shortstop or left fielder be able to get to if it hangs up in the air long enough. But right there, it just died and found a way to drop in on the green stuff with base hit.
First and second, one out. And here's the first baseman, Pete Alonso. He's already homered in this game. Line drive, caught. Throw not in time as he's able to get back to avoid the double play.
Yikes, that ball was scorched, an absolute missile, and it almost becomes self-defense as the fielder when one of those things comes screaming towards you. Watch your lips.
Escobar in the box now. No balls and a strike. In the air, left field. Olivares sizing it up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that will end the inning. One run in the inning, but they leave two. 9-1 and 2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Mets 9 and the Royals nothing. Well, we go bottom six, so up now for Kansas City, Nate Eaton. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
Oh, and two now. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
The batter number 11.
And stepping in is the speedy number 11.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
And that's in there for strike one.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there. I always remember watching Johan Santana pitch, and when he was in his prime, you would see a lot of guys out in front, right-handers pulling that change up in the stands and then fouling the fastball the opposite field up into the stands.
McNeil gets it to first. Two up, two down.
Now back, second baseman, Michael.
Here's the second baseman, Michael Massey.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
And a base hit into right. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
That's back-to-back singles for him. Nice line drive to the pole side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And now the first baseman, Vinny Pasquantino. His righty-lefty splits there. To the right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Welcome back. New inning getting started. And stepping in for New York, Starling Marte.
The designated hitter, Starling Marte.
The pitch. Next offering popped in the air, right field. One away.
The batter, the left fielder, Mark Canna.
Mark Canna now at the plate.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
Off the mark there, and it's 1-0.
Ball one, no strike.
And that one almost got him.
Straighten him up a little bit.
That one missed. Now 3-0. Now this is in the air down the line. Olivares sizing it up. Makes the grab on the run. And there's two down.
The batter, the catcher, Francisco Alvarez.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the catcher for the Mets, Francisco Alvarez. Out to center. Waters settles underneath it. Makes the grab, and that is the third out of the inning. Down in order go the Mets, but they're still in command. 9-0. And welcome back. Set for the last half of the seventh. And here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. And he deals. And a good eye there. The 1-1. And strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Lace down the line. This looks like extra bases. Makes the turn and heads for second. And he's there with a leadoff double. So a man aboard and to the plate for Kansas City, Edward Olivares. Hammered down the right side but foul. The pitch. Foul ball there. Runner leads away at second. Ground ball, Alonso. He takes it on his own. And one away in the bottom of the seventh.
The designated hitter, number 99.
Franmil Reyes, the next to hit.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, one strike.
Comebacker to the mound. And he's out on the tag.
The center fielder, number six, Drew
Waters. Digging in is the switch hitting outfielder, Drew Waters. Just missed.
Tried to backdoor him with that slider right there, but just missed off the plate. Good pitch, though.
The 1-0. And nope, that one just missed off the outside edge. Perez on third with two out. And now 2-1.
They haven't scored yet in this game. And with that swing, they're definitely trying to get on the board. That's the way guys go about their business today.
Next offering is fouled back. And here it comes. Smoked on the ground a second. Third out, and that ends the frame. So one left for Kansas City. Steep hill to climb. It's a 9-0 deficit.
There's a strange wind blowing. It's coming back.
Back here at the ballpark, we go to the eighth, and now the right fielder, Tim LoCastro. Clark back to work. That misses the zone, 1-0.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number nine hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
They say it went. Next offering is down low. And another ball. The 3-1. In the air, left side. Olivares moving under it. And out number one on the grab.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And that one is lifted in the air. Hops over the wall, and that's an automatic double.
The automatic double kind of feels like enjoying cruise control in your car, Boog. You don't need to keep the pedal down as you cruise into second base. Just no worries in the world. You know what? He put a really good swing on that one.
And now the shortstop, Francisco Lindor. Ball one, no strikes. They say it went.
1-1.
The 1-1 is fouled off. And a pitch. That one lifted to left. Olivares moving under it. Hauls it in for the out.
The batter number one, second baseman, Jeff McNeil.
Jeff McNeil stands in.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
And he swings and misses, and it's nothing and one.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
That misses. Ball one. The 1-1 is fouled off. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Nimmo around third. He'll score easily. It's 10-0.
There's nothing cheap about the way he got that one through the infield. That was ripped. Caught out in front and didn't get under it like he would have liked, but definitely put a good swing on it.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. He's already homered here in this one. Swings through that one. 0-1. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss. That is strike two.
He got away with one there, but he knows he can't go into that spot very often against a guy like this.
Foul ball still 0-2. Kicks and fires. Pitch misses there, and a count 1-2. Righty to the plate. And now 2-2. Two outs. And it's filled up.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
McNeil, the runner at first with two gone. In the air, out towards left center. Olivares moving under it. And that is that. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the Mets 10 and the Royals nothing. Bottom of the inning, here's the third baseman, Hunter Dozier.
The third baseman, Hunter Dozier.
Now into the ball game on defense, Luis Guillorme. He'll play second.
Now playing second. Number 13, Luis Guillorme.
Also entering the game, DJ Stewart. He'll be patrolling center field.
Number 86, DJ Stewart.
Also into the ball game, Brett Beatty. He's the new third baseman.
Now playing third base, number 22, Brett Beatty.
The right-hander back to work. And that's outside. Senga still out there to pitch the eighth and working with a big lead.
He's been excellent, really on his game in this one. And at this point, he wants to finish what he started.
Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. Is there a debate to be had about shutting him down, maybe to preserve some bullets given the score?
Absolutely. When you consider over the course of a long season, guys putting a lot of stress on that elbow, on that shoulder, but you also have to pry the ball out of a hand of a guy like this because he's so competitive.
good job of just putting the ball in play with two strikes.
That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Man at first, and next up for the Royals, Nate Eaton. Ball one there. A strike.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Nobody out. Runner at first. Got him looking for the K. Strike three called and a slider at the knees.
Oh, tough night at the dish. Punching out for the third time right there. He just hasn't looked very comfortable at the plate. A little unsure of his timing right now, not picking up the spin and location of these pitches. He'll have some adjustments to make.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, number 11. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Alvarez hauls it in, and there's two away.
The batter number 19, second baseman, Michael Massey.
So up now for Kansas City, Michael Massey. That misses the zone, and that is ball one.
Now just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
There's a strike.
Well, this looks like it's going to be a wasted opportunity. It's frustrating when you get the leadoff man on, but you can't get him into scoring position. They're going to need a big knock. Try to put something up on the board.
And a ball and two strikes.
Ball two.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
Next pitch just misses. And now three and two. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Here comes a 3-2. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Royals leave one, not looking good. They're down 10-0. Nick Wickren takes over on the mound.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleeding and keep the score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
So digging in, Brett Beatty taking his first at bat of the game after entering on defense. And the pitch. Line drive. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away.
The batter. The designated hitter,
Starling Marte, up now for the Mets. Wickren measures 6 feet, 2 inches, 215 pounds, and he was a ninth-round draft pick back in 2012.
Wow, no fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move till the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just going to have to tip your cap on that pitch.
No ball, two strikes.
And the righty deals. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. The pitch. Swing and a pop-up. Marte retired. And there are two outs.
Now batter, left fielder, Mark Canha.
Two outs, base is empty. So up next for New York, Mark Canha. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Olivares moving under it. Squeezes it. And that is that. Bottom of the ninth coming up, and we'll see if he can complete the shutout after the break. Bottom nine, and here's the first baseman, Vinny Pasquantino.
He's been so sharp today, even over 100 pitches thrown. His skipper is leaving him in there to finish the job.
Left field. Canna calls it in, and there's one away. And next will be the cleanup hitter, Salvador Perez. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. A little bit low.
1-0.
That's off the mark. Now two balls and a strike. And that one fouled off. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Now batting.
Not a bad slider by any means. It was down and away, but an even better job to spoil that thing. And he let it travel, didn't try to hook it. Man, that's a really good approach.
Edward Olivares steps in for the Royals. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Salvi around second, headed for third, and that's a double.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Here at the bottom of the ninth, one out. So here's the Royals DH, Franmil Reyes. Tylor McGill into the game.
Well, he struggled quite a bit, so this is another opportunity to get on the right track. He's given up more than one hit per inning pitch so far this season. Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, you know, maybe a long relief guy.
Hard hit to third. Uh-oh, throw goes to second. And they're down to their last out.
The batter, the center fielder, Drew.
So it's their last chance in this one. Drew Waters steps in for the Royals. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. That misses off the outside edge. Perez at third. Olivares at second with two gone. The 1-1 is fouled off. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. Right-handed reliever. In the dirt. Nice job behind the plate. Well done behind the dish. Second and third. Two down. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, I don't know what they did in the cage today or on the field for batting practice, but when you win by double digits, something is clicking. That batting coach feels pretty good about himself right now, but more so the players. They can't wait for the next one. Come back out, score, and get another W.
10-0, your final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Tonight, for the victorious New York Mets, 10 runs, 13 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For Kansas City, no runs, 7